Okay. All right, so we're going to play some Final Fantasy 14. I just got the setup all corrected, and I'm going to. Okay. There used to be. Okay, so we're going to be playing Final Fantasy 14, and I won't be using a camera unless I'm actually doing like a impressions video. So this won't be like a normal video. This is just kind of a kickback. Sometimes I have my friends on with me and stuff like that. This is just kind of a trial run to see how well it turns out. Alright, so we're going after the Nomu's enemies, and it looks like, we should go ahead and eat some food while we're doing this. That was a little hairy.
Thank you. Thank goodness. There you are. Those Numo were rather frightening. I'm glad you're safe. I haven't seen much actual combat, so I was a little nervous. But I'm happy I could help. The Minfilius before me battled Sin Eaters as part of the Yulmoran army. But that had all changed by the time I was found. They held me captive, so that I wouldn't follow in the others' footsteps. I'd still be in my cell now had Thancred not spirited me away. When he found me, I knew nothing of the world. I didn't know how to live, let alone fight. Thancred once told me that if the efforts to summon you failed, it would fall to me to face the Light Wardens. I realized then that it was the only reason he kept me close, as a contingency. The truth is, he can't stand to be around me, because I'm not her. I'm not his Minfilia. Once, we journeyed to Nabatharang together, to the place where the Oracle appeared and stayed the Flood. As we drew near, I felt as though I was fading away. I shut my eyes and covered my ears, and then... sure what happened after that. I have a vague feeling that I said something to him, Only afterwards, Thancred didn't say a word. Only kept to himself and brooded. There's nothing I can do for him. Nothing I can offer but my presence. Though it only reminds him of his loss. She should be the one to live on. That's why I tried to find you. Because I knew that was what she wanted. But now that you're here, I'm not entirely sure what it was she intended me to do. Was I meant to tell you something, or bring you to someone, or somewhere? I can feel the answer at the edge of my mind, just out of reach.
Why? Why did you imprison us? Such boredom, such tedium have we suffered. It is unfair. Unfair. Come. Come and play with us.
It came from the castle. This is everything I have. Please see it delivered to the Nemo. I will bear word to Thancred and the others.
Thank you. My medallion! You found it! Oh, I know not how to thank you. It is my most treasured possession. A gift from a dear departed soul. He was a traveler, and together we journeyed to the ends of the world and back again. When I was young. In those days, I could not speak. But we found joy in each other's company nonetheless. Oh, the memories. This medallion he found during an adventure, fashioned it into a necklace for me, his partner in crime. I had not the words to tell him then, but it filled my heart with pride. I was so, so happy. His name was Artbert, and he was my friend.
Artbert, thou sayest?
Everyone blamed him for the flood. Him and his comrades. Some few who spoke up for them, of the many whose lives they had touched. But as the years went by, their voices were drowned out by those who only uttered the adventurers' names as a curse. It was too much to bear. And so I left behind men and their lies, and came to this place. Artbert was a trusting soul, constantly being drawn into the troubles of others. Yet in spite of this, he never thought twice when he saw someone in need. He always tried to help. It was no different then. The world needed heroes. It needed him. And yet, he was a good man. He deserved to be happy. I wish I could have told him that, at least. You remind me of him. Your kindness. When we Amaro were created, we were granted the ability to perceive souls. Thus did we recognize our masters. That ability has long since faded from our kind. But due, perhaps, to my reversion, I can see your soul. Faintly, but surely. it is reminiscent of Ardbert's. Strikingly so. Of course, you are you and no one else. We are defined not by the soul we are born with, but the path we walk. Nevertheless, I cannot help but feel that this is more than mere coincidence. Which is why I will place my faith in you. The relic, it is yours.
Something happened at Leader Loran.
Together with the twins, we were playing tricks on some nasty mortals to stop them from setting foot in Il Meg. At first, they ran off screaming, which was lots of fun. But then a scary, bony, wrinkly old mortal came along and spoiled everything. None of our tricks seemed to work on him, which is no fun at all. And now they're getting closer and closer.
Ranjit. If he manages to find his way in, all our efforts will have been for naught.
As thou sayest. Should we be discovered ere our mission here is complete and the Light Warden yet liveth, our task will be rendered nigh impossible. If we are to prevail, we must needs divide our forces. Thus do I propose the following. Whilst thou salliest forth to meet with the Light Warden, we shall join in the effort to obstruct the trespassers. Should we succeed in staying their advance, all the better. Yet even should we fail, if we can but delay our enemy's arrival long enough for thee to secure victory, our plan may still be deemed a success.
So the moment the lights go out, we all beat a hasty retreat, yes?
Let me come with you. I have the blessing, too.
No, Mithilia. You'll only get on the foot. Now come.
I wish there were more I could do. Please be careful.
Thank you.
have freed our fallen king. Not that I expected any less, my Sneyak. The dress, the crown, the scepter, the shoes. The time has come for these relics to serve their true purpose. For they are not only keys to the castle, they are also blessings to be bestowed upon the new king. The way into the castle is opened when it is time to relieve the reigning monarch of the throne. And the brave soul who does the deed has the honor of taking their place. However, should you ascend the throne, you will become one of us, never again to live as men do. My adorable sapling, my precious mortal. We fey folk live forever, but such is not your virtue. Strive for a dream you will never see. To sow seeds that others might one day taste the fruits of your garden. That is the beauty of your kind. Burn bright and shine as only you can. These blessings, your lovely branch will accept in your stead. Shall we attend to those unwise enough to trespass in our realm?
Confound it! How did they get here so fast?
These pixies and their tricks.
How in the seven hells?
Listen well. We come in pursuit of villains who have fled to this land. You know who and where they are. Now show yourselves and answer me before I lose my patience.
Oh, it hurts! It hurts!
Enough! Lift the enchantment!
Minfilia, willful child, how many times must I come to collect you?
I won't return to Yulmore, and I won't let you hurt my friends.
What is this stance? Where did you learn it? No oracle I trained would make such an unseemly show of herself. Know your shame, girl. You're powerless. You have no life nor purpose, save that which our master sees fit to permit.
are you to dictate her purpose? To lock her away and deny her a life? If she was powerless, it's because of you, you sanctimonious swine. But no longer.
Fool! Defiance only begets more suffering. It is through acceptance alone that one may find solace in this God's forsaken world.
Look! The sky! He's done it. The Warrior of Darkness has triumphed!
General? What are our orders? What do we do?
We do what we came to do. Subdue this rabble and find the Warrior of Darkness.
Forward, men! Take the villains captive! Are you deaf? I said...
Axla Orwain!
Axla Orwain!
What? What's happening?
Water? That wasn't there before.
What's the matter with you? Get a hold of yourselves, damn it! General, they come in greater numbers. We must retreat!
All who stand with a Warrior of Darkness shall face justice. My master demands it.
I see. Well, it's a good thing Fair all volunteered to become king in your stead, for all our sakes.
We are grateful for your timely aid, Fair all, or should I say, your majesty.
That was the first night in recent memory. We all of us but wished to make the most of it. That's something you must remember about us fey folk. Though our existence may be eternal, we exist only for the present.
Hey.
We live in the here and now, paying no mind to futures that may or may not be. To wit, we are not driven as men are. We cannot fight for such causes as men do.
Does that mean you won't aid us against the Sin Eaters?
Not unless the mood takes us. But if it was to repay a debt, well then, that's another matter. To take back as much as is taken. To create as much as is destroyed. To give as much as is received. Such is the way of Ilmeg. By this law, we shall lend you our strength. In return for the beautiful sky you have restored to us. In times of need, do not hesitate to call. Silly sapling. I shall remain at your side. Even should my body be in the castle, 'tis a simple thing to have a little part of me accompany you. Treat them as you would your Isnephis.